Is it even worth using Xcode extension these days? No, if you don't want to edit code faster. So yes, the answer is yes, do use Xcode extensions. And today I'm going to show you my favorite 5 Xcode extensions and why you should install them right now. By the way, they are all free, so let's see how you can write better code with my top 5 Xcode extensions. And if you do like my teaching style, go ahead and check out Dev Factory. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. It's a 60-minute Zoom call with me. Maybe you want to learn Swift UI, I can teach you that. Or maybe you want me to take a look at your code, maybe debug it. I can also do that. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, what we are going to talk about today is my top 5 favorite Xcode extensions. Now, all of these are a part of the Mac App Store. So what you want to do, you want to download them, just go under Xcode and Xcode extensions, and that will open up the Mac App Store actually, and it's just going to go to the Xcode extensions, and all of my favorites are downloaded from here. So my first one, and you need to install it and you need to enable it inside settings. I will do that with my very top favorite one, the last one. So if you want to skip around this video, go ahead and check out the chapters also down below here. And the 4 last of the top 5 are actually right over here. I have already added that. Again, the top 1 will be added at the end of this video. So the first one, actually top number, 5, is comment wrapper. And it actually does what it says. It's going to wrap your comments. Now, if you just go maybe to jump to definition under image and system, you see we have all of these nicely wrapped comments for, Apple documentation. And here I have this really, really long one. So what can we do? We just select that line, okay, because this is just one line. Then a comment wrapper, we want to wrap it to 40 characters. And that's what it is. Now, if you want to undo that, we just select all of the lines, of course, and select unwrap under content wrapper. Now, let me just wrap that again. Maybe this time I'm going to do that with 60. And let's add in here some Alex extensions, whatever. And as you can see now, this one is a little bit longer. So what I want to do is just select again all of them. And under Editor, Comment Wrapper, let's rewrap it to 60 again. And there we go. We are rewrapping that comment. And it's as simple as that. It's really, really powerful for using comment wrapping. Now, number 4 is Editor Plus, and actually it's also this line, and because both of them are inside Text Plus. Now, for example, in Editor Plus, I don't really like these two lines right over here, so I'm just going to go Editor and remove comment, and it's just going to simply remove that comment. It's as simple as that. Let's move that back. And also, we can use add type delegate, add type extensions, but we can use this line part. So we can just copy line, move line down, delete the line, clear, join line, split line. You know, there are some more below, you can't see it right now, but it's really, really nice to handle and edit a line. So let's just move a line up. There we go. We just moved that line up. Okay. So number 3 is text toolset. And again, this is about editing text in Xcode. Like, we can delete lines, duplicate lines, uppercase selections, lowercase selections, block comment. This is really, really nice because, let's say I want to block comment these parts, just go editor, text toolset, and block comment. You didn't really see that because, the menu is unseeable on my window right over here. But this is how you can do that real, real quickly. Okay, now we come to number 2. This is a really, really nice XCFORMAT. So format active file or format selected line. So let's just see. Let's do some really bad formatting right over here. I'm going to remove the block comment. And maybe just add in here some tabs. There we go. And the body, this is badly formatted. And if you are not using you know, default tabs and all of that, this could happen. Or if maybe you are just simply copy and pasting from Stack Overflow or whatnot. So what I want you to do is just select all of these and then just go Editor, XCFORMAT, and Format Selected Lines or Active File. Now I'm just going to go with Selected Lines because I know I have selected them. So there we go. We just formatted all of that. Now if I just go back, and I don't have to select anything right over here, I just go Editor, XCFORMAT, and Active File. There we go. It's just going to indent all of that. Now, also, we have here, let's just see, let's say import foundation, maybe. And just go Editor and Format Active File. And as you can see, it just switched the foundation and the Swift UI import, because actually that is the recommended way of formatting our, you know, our import one by line in alphanumeric order. Okay, and now it's time for our number one. And I'm going to take you step by step how to do this. And you have to do all of the steps for the previous extensions also. So here we go. Let's just go and open up Xcode extensions. There we go. And I'm just going to scroll down till I see Code Cows. So I'm just going to download this. And yeah, by the way, there are a lot more Xcode extensions on the Mac App Store. So please do take a look at them also. Let's just open this up. Okay, it's fine. We can just quiz that really nicely. So what we want to do is just enable this inside our settings. So you just want to open System Settings and just search for extensions. There we go. And you will see this Xcode Source Editor. And of course, I have already installed this, but you will have this unchecked. And any of the new Xcode extensions will be unchecked. So you want to check that and then just click on Done. Okay, and maybe you want to also restart Xcode, but hopefully we can see this already inside the editor. There we go. It's Cowsy Editor. So what I'm going to do here is just add these two forward slashes and I just go into editor, Cowsy Editor, and just go cow of the day. And there we go. This is the cow of the day. It's really, really funny for other developers to see all of these Easter eggs inside your code. This is my number one pick for Xcode extensions. Now, if you did like this video, go ahead and do please check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call. And go ahead and check out my previous video about progress buttons. It's right over here.